Last time on Gravity Rush Remastered. Blank room behind your bed. I heard this sweet sound of water. It's a shower. If only I was the black cat, Blank, we could be together forever. Dusty. I dream of living in a blank with you. In a pipe house. Oh no, I pushed the wrong one. That's great. Hey guys, Ren here, and welcome back to Gravity Rush Remastered. So, basically, we have one more side mission and about four more story missions, maybe five? So we're almost done with the game, and there are some things I wanted to talk about. I don't know, like, I've seen you guys recommend these, information dialogues all over the place, but I don't know, every time I do one, it's not all that interesting, and for the most part, they're spread out everywhere. Like, in order to clear all the ones that show up, or all these little dialogue boxes that show up every single other mission, I should say, or every single mission, I have to travel between all four places just to talk to one person, and that's, I don't know, that's a bit of a hassle, so even if we do miss it, Even if we do miss it, there's a point of no return, but the thing is, they disappear after a while. So it's also like, I don't know. But on the bright side, we're about to do the second side, or the last side mission, which is for the military DLC. So let's get started. Hopefully we get a sick outfit from this. I've liked all the outfits so far, maybe minus the cat one, surprisingly, as I think a lot of people actually like the Catwoman outfit. I don't know, just the motorcycle helmet makes it look weird. They should have just kept the helmet off. Special Forces Headquarters, this looks like the right place.
Hey, you there. This area is off limits to civilians.
What's this guy's problem? I'm only on government property, jeez. I'm Kat, and I'm here to see Yuri Gurnu, the commander for the Special Forces.
Did you say Kat? So you're the shifter, huh? Hold on.
Beep, beep.
Yes, sir. Understood, sir. I'll send her up right away, sir. Oh, and those sweet little cookies you write. Yeah, I got them at the supermarket. Well, I mean, yes, sir. She'll be right up. The commander is waiting on the battleship. Oh, they're flying ship. Yeah, I almost forgot about that somehow. You can go inside. We'll issue you a visitor's pass.
A visitor's pass? That seems kind of formal. All right.
Whoa, I love that. I think that's my favorite piece of art in this whole thing. I love that shot of Kat. That's awesome. Oh, and sorry my voice is a little off. I've been sick the past few days, and I've been trying to keep my voice at a minimum, I guess I should say. Have you come around to the idea of enlisting, Shifter?
Well, I'm not sure yet, but so much has happened in the last year. I wanted to find out more about what's been going on since I was away.
All right, then let me fill you in. When Denelcia came into power about a year ago, we received the go-ahead from the Jellyfish Special Forces Unit to better respond to the growing Nevi threat.
Is that not Kat? Damn.
If, like, just the slight tone in their skin and their eye color, I'd swear that they were the same person or sisters. And I'm not just saying that because they're blonde, but just, I don't know, they're so very close. Head shape's a little different, though.
Thanks to us, the Nevi aren't a problem anymore. You're not going to be a problem, are you? What are you talking about? Why would I be a problem?
Siwa, stand down. God damn this cat fighting. Get it? Get it? Because you're a cat.
Commander, this is not funny.
Oh, she should have like a stuck up accent of some kind.
Commander, this is not funny.
Yeah, that's a good one. The Jellyfish can use all the help we can get, and the Shifter would make a powerful ally.
My apologies, sir.
Although the Nevi threat has been contained, their behavior is so unpredictable that we can't rest until the last of their kind are eradicated.
Doesn't that seem a little harsh?
No, they must all die. Shifter, we could use someone like you, and I think you'll find it easier to understand the changes that have occurred to Hekseville from the inside.
It would be nice to fight alongside someone for a change. Alright, I'll take you up on your offer.
Excellent. Siwas, prepare a uniform for the new recruit, and take her through the basic training.
I think she's too fat to fit in any of our uniforms, sir.
I'm still here, you wanna go?
Yes, sir. Come with me for your uniform.
She's like a female Edgeworth almost voice. Or Clavier. What? Ooh! I like this one. She even has a... What do you call those things? Those little singular hairs or whatever. It's like an... okay? A something? Augie? Whatever. I don't exactly know how it's actually pronounced. I feel so professional in this thing. It fits like a glove. What do you think? Do I look good in the uniform? I'll expect you to obey my orders. Now follow me to the basic training. She's always so on edge. Basic training. Permit, is everything ready? Whoa, who's this lady? There's not enough of her. She has a good design. Why doesn't she talk more? Yes, the training ground is ready. You're free to begin the trial. Roger that. Come with me, Shifter. I'll explain the rules when we get there. This accent still needs some work, and doesn't help that I'm kind of sick. Now let's go over the rules. The following trial is designed to test combat reflexes. Nevi dummies have been set up throughout the area. Dummies? But I'm already used to fighting the real thing. A soldier must maintain composure in the face of any challenge. You can't just let things get out of control. That kind of attitude isn't just dangerous to you. It's dangerous to everyone around you. I'm not dangerous. Yes, ma'am. So I just need to complete the trial, right? You don't need to do anything. If you want to quit, feel free to go home. Why does she have to be so mean all the time? I'm not going anywhere. The combat readiness trial is conducted in pairs in order to bring out the best in our new recruits through competition. Oh my god, is Raven? No, Raven can't show up. I will be your partner to- Oh, okay. Lucky me. Alright, let's just get this started. I'm always ready for action. Huh, we'll see about that. Permit, our new recruit says she's ready to begin the trial. Roger that, commencing the trial. Nevi dummies are ready for deployment. I spent all damn night making these dummies. I have nothing better to do. I mean, I was hanging out with my boyfriend. Destroy the Nevi dummies in this combat trial. The participant who destroys the most dummies wins. Okay, yeah, she's a boss fight. She has animations. There's no way she's not a boss fight. Or something. What? Why are they disappearing? Oh my goodness, she's killing them before I can... I know Sea Wasp is in the lead and it's stupid. She keeps killing all the ones I'm going for. It seems like she's specifically targeting the ones I'm going after, too. This isn't a competition to see who can take the... Or to see who can take the most out. It seems like a competition to see who can steal each other's points. Oh, no! That yellow stuff is actually from our max level gravity kick. Because I was able to upgrade gravity kick to the max level, and now it has a different animation. Not really a different animation, but it has a glowing tint to it. That's pretty cool, actually. I didn't expect that. Makes me wonder what the max level gravity torrent looks like, or whatever the rock throw thing is called. Victory is in my hands. Or in my feet, as I'm using one move over and over again. This isn't really impressive for combat training. So, Commander, what do you think of her abilities? Well, she's really good at kicking. I can say that 100%. Her kick is so good. What about her other abilities? That's fine, she doesn't really need it. Wait, was that someone yelling? Meow. But I can't leave now. They'll think I left the trial. I'll be kicked out of the special forces. I know. It's not in my nature to ignore someone in trouble. No, Cat, ignore it. Win the competition. The Shifter has left the battlefield. In the middle of basic training. Oh, this is gonna cause conflict, isn't it? Who are you? I don't recognize you. Are you a new recruit? Were you hurt? Is it serious? I better get you to the hospital. No, you can't do that. I'm in the middle of an important mission, right outside of our base for whatever reason. I was just promoted to the special forces. I can't let them down now. What are you talking about? We follow a strict code. Once underway, the mission takes first priority. I just have to fight the pain. Sounds like you're losing that fight. Look at you, you can barely move. You need to get that wound looked after. Wait, I need to get this message to Commander. This is my chance to get noticed. Senpai will notice me. How about I help you out? I just have to deliver the message. I just have to deliver you and the message to the Commander, right? No, I can't let you do that. If they saw a recruit helping me, I'd never hear the end of it. Well, just keep that between ourselves then. Besides, What good are you going to be to the jellyfish if you let that injury get worse? Just let me help, and once you've delivered the message, get yourself to a hospital.
I'm gonna laugh when we still win. So you're the shifter everyone's talking about.
I didn't even get to read that, because he stopped talking.
No one saw that at all. Not a single soul.
Commander, I have important orders straight from central government for your eyes only. Good work, soldier. I don't know why we have the same voice, practically, but whatever. These orders are crucial to the next step of our plan. If these had fallen into the hands of the resistance... Thank you, sir, but I can't take all the credit.
If he tells them I helped, he might get in trouble. Commander, this soldier is hurt. Is there a doctor on board who can look after his injuries?
I know Kat's voice is super weird right now, but my throat hurts like hell. Shifter, what are you doing back here? Shouldn't you be undergoing basic training with Sea Wasp?
Commander, I'm afraid I have bad news to report about a new recruit. Uh-oh, here it comes.
Oh, Jesus. Something's slightly off with your face.
Oh my god. The shifter left in the middle of basic training. I recommend the candidate for immediate dishonorable discharge. If I tell them the truth now, I'll get that soldier in trouble. Well, I guess if it's your decision, I don't have any choice but to... Commander, abnormal gravity fluctuations are occurring around Von Sant. We've got new Nevi. We've got Nevi inbound.
Nevi here?
Oh, let me guess. Kat's gonna take out the Nevi and they're gonna be like, damn, you're so good. Too bad Sea Wasp can't be like you.
Oh my goodness, that is a literal shitstorm up there.
I really hate those, like, spiny ones. Like the minefield ones. Those ones suck. I hate biting them.
Whoa, those are cool anti-Nevi vehicles. Reports from Nevi are coming in from all over Von Sant. Citizens have been ordered to evacuate the local authorities, and the local authorities have requested assistance from the jellyfish. Nevi, we have to get out of here and help those people.
Evacuation to civilians takes first priority. Do your best to keep collateral damage to a minimum.
Seawas, do whatever you can to keep the Nevi from spreading further downtown. Then back the rescue forces up if you can. Roger that. Heading out.
Shifter, basic training's over. It's time to see how you handle real action. From now on, your code name is Sea Cat. Sea Cat, get yourself downtown and rescue any stranded civilians.
Sea Cat? That's kind of a weird name considering cats don't like water, but...
Yes, sir. Heading out.
Beep. Hey, it's not Sid this time. It's Lady.
Civilian spotted downtown around Main Street. Sea Cat, head down there ASAP.
Sea Cat? Oh, that's me! I almost forgot.
Roger that, madam. I'm heading out. The closest evacuation zone is the Loop Line Station. When you've secured the civilians, escort them there. The area above the building skyline is off limits. It will be under heavy fire, and we can't afford to have any civilian casualties. Roger. I'll stay low when evacuating the people to the Loop Line Station.
Escort the civilians to safety. Okay, cool. I've heard that there is a part of one of these military missions that is extremely annoying that has to do with towers or something. Can I escort them all at once? No, I can't. Or at least it's trying to tell me I can't. I don't know where the other ones are now because it took the marker off.
Sir? Sir?
He died, didn't he?
Oh no, he's right here. You survived. Thanks to the magical city god powers that put you back wherever I took you from.
Whoa, these Nevi are...
Oh, come on.
Okay, you know what? They have to go down.
Is that thing really not taking any damage? What the hell?
That was a complete waste. I need to get rid of this thing. It's in the way.
Ugh, goddamn. These things are tough.
I'm mainly just getting pelted by everything, and that's why it's tough.
There we go. Okay. So this should not be nearly as difficult now.
Another one just spawned? I just took you...
Whatever. One civilian... Okay, that is finally over.
I have to say, the problem with these DLCs and why I don't think they're worth it is because the costumes are cool. They're all really good. And what's there, it's just... When it comes to the mechanics of the DLC, DLC's a place where you want to differentiate from the game. It's where you go to put in those ideas that didn't originally make it in because some time reason or budget or something. The problem with the DLCs, though, is a lot of them... Maybe the first one was a little bit more imaginative, but a lot of them just include doing the same thing we've done before, which is carry thing, kill Nevi. That's it, and it's really kind of disappointing, but we'll see how this one ends. Beep. Civilian spotted near Loop Line Station 2. C-Cat, head out there ASAP. Multiple Nevi sightings have been reported in that area. Roger, heading out. Come on, Dusty, we better hurry.
Oh my god, you joined the military? I've been sleeping the whole goddamn time.
What are we doing? We're protecting the plans for Metal Gear.
Oh my god, I knew it was happening. I don't know why I'm so southern like Sid now, too. Probably because Zeno can't pull off this voice because his throat feels like 1,000 spears have been shoved down it.
C-Cat, you're too high up. You're entering our cannon fire.
I don't care. I do what I want.
F the jellyfish.
Uh-oh. This isn't working.
Oh, there's more civilians.
Why? And he's dead. Okay, then. And now that's wasted and gone. These missions aren't that difficult because it's really hard to lose them. There's no time limit or anything.
I want my mommy and daddy.
Well, that sucks. It's just, they're kind of annoying. You're just supposed to fly them from point A to point B, and there's a million little things set up to stop you. It's very hard to make an escort mission fun. There are some ways, like Resident Evil 4. Well, the whole thing's an escort mission, and I don't mind. But then there are a lot of ways.
I want my mommy, I want my daddy, I'm so scared.
Everything's gonna be okay. Just man up, you little girl. Your mommy and daddy are probably just waiting inside for you.
Thank you, soldier lady. I'm so glad you're here for us, especially after that gravity girl went away. I want to be a soldier like you someday.
She doesn't know who I am. She really just thinks I'm another soldier. You can be anything you want.
I'm sorry. I used to think you were scary, but I don't think that anymore. Thank you for saving me.
You're welcome? Oh, by the way, I highly don't recommend joining this shit show of a military. It sucks. Now go find your mommy and daddy.
Okay, so what to do next?
Oh, that's right, we still have 3 more stranded civilians. Whoa.
Okay, so I have a lot of complaints with this mission. First of all, I mean, I understand that there has to be a ceiling somehow and you have to make it fitting. Why not just put an invisible wall? Why is it that when I fly too high in a game that is meant for flying, that it teleports me back to the ground with the person I was carrying back where they were because I flew too high? You could just put an invisible wall or something. Also, you may not want to have the enemies respawn after you kill them. I understand you also want it to be an obstacle course of sorts, but what is fun about killing an enemy, going to pick up whoever you're going to pick up, and then immediately after you pick them up, the enemy appears out of thin air behind you, hits you in the back, and causes you to drop them off a cliff. I'm sorry if I sound like I'm complaining a lot this episode, but just honestly, I'm not really impressed with this DLC. It's not great. Outfits, once again, great. I love them. Story bits, meh, sometimes don't make sense, but it's fine. Gameplay, nope. Beep.
Nevi encountered near the plaza evacuation zone. We don't have enough troops in the area to hold them off. The Nevi are breaking through the perimeter. Right, I'm heading to the plaza now. The battleship and sea wasps will deal with the Nevi above, and the Nevi above the city skyline. C-Cat, guard the entrance to the evacuation zone. Leave it to me.
Okay, at least there's no more civilian carrying now.
God damn it, they're all so heavy.
It does look a lot. Cat's flying versus a regular superhero's flying. Cat seems to have a more relaxed time of it. Since she's literally just falling in the direction she's having gravity rotated to, it's just kind of her laying there in space as she travels. And I would way prefer gravity powers over just the ability of flight or something.
because flight, it seems like you have to exert some sort of force in order to do.
Well, shifting the gravity so you're floating.
Okay, we need health. We need health badly.
Well, shifting the gravity.
Oh my goodness. Okay, I just spawned, please. Oh my goodness. This is what I'm talking about if you can't see. Do you see how easy it is for it to go, no, you went too far, turn around. It's so weird. It's like the game is going against its own principles. It's a game designed so you can be free and fly around and do things, and then it turns around and says, hey, don't fly there. I understand there being a boundary, but... Oh my goodness, this mission is hard. Okay, and finally we're done. Sorry if it just sounds like I complained a lot this episode. But there... Oh, I guess not. But there's just... I don't know, there's just a lot of really bizarre design choices that... go against what the game's trying to do, in my opinion. All fixed. Sea Cat, the plaza has been contained. Oh, we're back on the base now. Sea Cat, you did well on your first mission. I can see we gained ourselves a valuable ally.
I've got to thank you all. A little girl told me about all the good you've done. You were there for the city when I wasn't.
Gratitude is a rare reward for a soldier. Treasure it. There are many civilians who don't support us or the new government, but at the end of the day, we have to fight for what we believe in. Sea Cat, we're about to undertake an important operation. I hope you can join us in seeing it through.
She is so discontent. She is almost worse. No, she is worse than Raven. Because Raven, at least, was just like... It's hard to say if she was worse than Raven.
Seawasp seems kind of upset. I've been meaning to ask, but Seawasp and Sea Cat are code names, right? What's your real name? I was just, you know, curious.
I am a soldier and only a soldier. Seawasp is the only name I need.
I see. Well, Seawasp it is then.
Her name is Unica.
God damn it! I was being so cool and you messed it all up. Commander, with all due respect...
Unica, I know it hasn't been easy growing up in these special circumstances, being a genetically modified soldier and all, but... Hey, I mean, Metal Gear couldn't be built in a day. But I hope you can learn to work together with Sea Cat. I'm sure the two of you will make me proud.
Yes, sir.
Sea Cat, that goes for you too. I expect you and Seawasp to set an example for the troops. That is all for today. Dismissed.
So Seawasp's name is Unica, huh? It's actually kind of cute.
Yes, sir. Come on, Dusty. Let's go home for some R&R.
What are you talking about, R&R? All you do is roll around in your bed and sing terrible pop music all day.
That's R&R.
And so ended my first mission as a Sea Cat, the newest member of Hekseville Special Forces, the Jellyfish. I do like the name Jellyfish. I do like the name the Jellyfish for a military squad. I think that's really cool. They were there for Hekseville when I wasn't, and I had them to thank for keeping the city safe. I would later find that safety can come at a cost, but that's another story for another time.
In fact, it's in 5 seconds when Zeno goes back to do the second part of the story.
Ooh, our rep just went up. It's been a whole year. Surely the Ark must be back by now.
Yeah, I kind of wonder what happened to the Ark. If it's been a whole year, is Raven going to come back and she's going to be a bit older? Or would Raven... What if Raven comes through and she aged into like an old lady?
That's all possibilities. But anyways, now... We're an idle shifter. Well, we still can't upgrade Gravity Typhoon to max, but that really doesn't matter too much. There are a lot of other things you can upgrade. I haven't even done all of the challenge missions. But hey, let's just go on to the next story mission. Or side mission, sorry.
I better get into uniform. Time to do those poses I like to do.
How is her uniform all sparkly and shit? Did your uniform come with glitter? No, it didn't. Come on, let's go down to the dollar store and get some glitter. Damn, she looks good.
Cat or Sea Cat here. I'm here on the commander's orders.
Sea Cat, you're late.
The operation is almost underway. Get up on the battleship bridge.
That's right. Yuri mentioned something about an important operation. Okay, I better get moving then. Come on, Dusty.
Why are you back here? They treat you like shit.
It's all part of being a soldier and an idol.
It's so hard to do the snake voice. It really is with a sore throat.
See, Cat, we don't have much time, but I'll try to explain. The Jellyfish have received orders straight from the top to proceed with a new plan to capture Nevi for research. And today is the day we carry out that plan.
Capture Nevi? What are you going to do with them?
Were those the orders that wounded soldier delivered?
Sea Cat, those orders are classified. Keep your curiosity in check, soldier.
You mean the orders he just told us about?
But can the Nevi even be trapped?
Our top secret research labs have developed a harvester that can attract and trap Nevi. This operation will also serve as a test for that technology. I'm afraid the plans for the Nevi after they've been captured are classified.
They sure like their secrets. Just tell me this, will this plan keep Hekseville safe?
Of course, and you're a critical member of the operation. We need you to help escort the battleship to the destination and protect it while the harvester does its job.
Alright, I don't really understand what's going on at all, and I mean, I'm not even really getting paid for this, I'm doing it for fun, but I'll do whatever I can for help. To help. Sea Cat, it is not our place to question orders.
I'm sorry, just stop.
Seawass, Sea Cat, man your positions. The operation is about to commence. Permit.
Power supply check. All stations ready, charting the flight course now. I get to say a bunch of cool shit like it's Gundam. Ooh. I wish I could fly.
Cat, you can fly.
Oh yeah, that's right.
This job sucks.
Well, if it helps protect the city, I'll do my part.
Stinger 1 to Jelly Mama. All clears on Jelly Mama? Really? That's the code name? Gravitational anomaly detected. Oh.
I'm sure he's okay. It was just accident. Happens.
I'm going down.
Click. What just happened? All the communications with Stinger 1 just cut off. Commander, I'm getting some new information. There's an abnormal gravity field, and it's bigger than anything we've seen before.
I swear, they put some, like, insane amounts of detail into portraits for characters that show up, like, one time. And they just turned her portrait around.
An abnormal gravity field? That's what we were told to be on the lookout for. What does this mean?
Yes, exactly what we've been waiting for. I've been waiting for this. Permit, what's our distance to the rendezvous point?
Hey, I hate to interrupt this, but a pilot just crashed. I'm going to check on him.
ZK, you're not authorized to leave your post. The mission takes priority.
Wait, what? How does a mission take priority over someone's life?
The mission is critical to the safety of the city. We managed to predict the location of the Nevi outbreak, and we may not get another chance at this.
Safety? What about the safety of our men? Is the mission worth their lives? This is nonsense.
Not asking you to understand me. This mission is vital to Hekseville's safety. I gave you an order. Maintain your station.
I'm going to save the pilot.
Sea Cat, return to your post. God damn it.
Well, I mean, since they won't... Like, that's the worst part about this and completely what I expected. They're gonna ask Cat to do some things that she morally just can't. And that's kind of what I thought would happen.
Are you alright?
Yeah, I'll live, but my head hurts.
But I think it's just a mild concussion. The engine got damaged in the crash and it's leaking fuel. That stuff is sensitive to changes in gravity, so don't shift gravity around here, it'll spark a chain reaction.
Chain reaction? What am I supposed to do if I can't shift gravity?
Just let me repair this leak. Once it's fixed, I can work on getting this thing back in the air. Alright, but try to hurry it up. Oh, and Nevi? And I'm not allowed to use my gravity powers either?
Nevi, what wonderful timing.
The leaking fuel must be attracting the Nevi, Sea Cat. Keep those Nevi away from the ship while I get the leak under control.
And how am I supposed to fight without shifting gravity?
I'll do what I can to buy you time, but you better hurry.
Fuel is leaking from the crash fighter. If you shift gravity, you might spark an explosive chain reaction big enough to kill both you and the pilot.
Well, if it's just a pilot, I wouldn't care.
Avoid using any of your gravity powers until the pilot can repair the leak.
Oh, this is gonna suck. I haven't upgraded kick at all. Oh, this is great. This is the one instance where I need it. There we go.
Nevi, but I can't shift gravity with that fuel leak.
We're gonna have to be pretty creative with this. Don't tell me that. Okay, good.
I need to buy that pilot more time to repair the ship.
Well, then repair the ship. Without our gravity powers, we really suck. I mean, granted, this is the one time I will call our normal combo useful. But it's only because the game is limiting us to using it. There we go. Please tell me there's no more. Hurry up and repair the ship. I don't know how long I can keep this up. I can barely keep this up as is, honestly.
It takes an hour to kill just the slightly overcharged regular Nevi.
There we go. Finally. The sharks aren't so bad either. These plants, I don't know about, especially since I think they're armored. And we did it, finally.
Sea cat, I fixed the leak.
Phew, I wasn't sure how long I could hold.
Hold, oh my goodness, my voice is destroyed.
Hold them off without being able to shift.
Thank you for the assistance. Once I fix the rest of this thing up, we can get back to the fleet. There's still time to assist in the operation.
Wait, go back? But Yuri just left you to die. How can you think of going back to him?
The commander had his reasons. Any jellyfish worth the name would gladly lay down their lives for him.
She's like, you cray cray. Huh? Oh, there's a report coming over the radio.
Nevi sighted around the battleship. They're acting irregular.
Get that harvester online.
Harvester not responding and it's drawing power away from the primary systems. We're losing our engines.
What?
Oh, that does not look like a good at all.
It's fine. I'm sure they're doing fine up there.
Those are just the backup fires.
Beep.
Fire confirmed on the outer hull. Repeat, fire on the outer hull.
Damn it, I knew I should have bought those fire extinguishers instead of donuts.
I'll take care of the fires.
Wait, I'm getting reports that Nevi have appeared in the city. There's a massive outbreak in Plejean. They're requesting assistance.
Seawash, the civilians come first. Protect Plejean.
But Commander!
Seawash, that's an order. The mission has changed. The harvester is offline and our first priority is to protect the people. Get over to Plejean.
Yes, sir. Heading to Plejean.
Plejean, I guess I should say.
That sounds bad. That's not good, really.
Fire's breaking out on the battleship? Nevi all over Plejean?
Z-Cat, we've got to help the battleship. Seawash can take care of Plejean. I'll stay here and do what I can to get this ship in the air.
Return to the battleship. Okay, see ya, dude. And what's up here?
Fire is broken out on the battleship. If the battleship's hull condition drops to zero, it'll go critical and crash into the city.
Oh, I knew there were fire extinguishers!
Grab fire extinguishers from the battleship or water tanks from around this. Oh, okay, so I remember this is one of the parts I heard people complaining about. Something about fire extinguishers.
What? Is the fire extinguisher just gone?
Well, I don't know what to do about it now.
Fire extinguisher? Did it. There aren't any more fire extinguishers, though. Like, we're out of fire extinguishers. What is that down there? I feel like I've missed something.
There were two fire extinguishers and one just exploded, so I don't know exactly.
Fire is spreading around the rest of the ship. All systems offline.
Because the fire extinguishers are gone. All hands abandon ship. Repeat, all hands abandon ship. Game over. Even though I'm still clearly standing on the ship. Surprised they didn't just reuse the explosion from that bomb mission. Oh, I have to fly back up there now. This time I'm going to try to read all the dialogue. The battleship is on fire. Fire's broken up on the battleship. Grab fire extinguishers from the battleship or water tanks from around the city.
Wow, I can't believe I forgot about that in that short time. It's just I noticed that this one broke instantly after I picked it up. That was accurate. It's crappy and flies all over the place. There we go. Okay. Beep. We're getting reports of fires breaking out in Vonsant. First the battleship, now the city.
Z-Cat, get down to the city and put those fires out. The civilians in the city come first.
But I can't just let the battleship burn. Don't make me choose. Do whatever it takes to save you and the city.
Cat, I think you're butting off a bit more than you can chew.
There's a water tower there. I'm glad they're actually making use of these tiny little water towers. I've always seen them all over the city, and I just sometimes throw them around for fun, but half the time they end up not doing anything. I mean, once you understand this mission, it's not that bad, honestly. What? Auto-tracking? I wanted to put the fire out, not throw it at the Nevi. I was even aiming at the fire, too. Oh, well. There's another water tank. Oh, there's several up here. Okay. Jackpot.
Jackpot.
Okay, so this time I just do the thing, and done. Game's over. I beat it. Oh, no. Well, the hull is now no longer being damaged. I think. Don't tell me they're going to start more fires while I'm putting out the ones in the city. Please don't. That was nowhere near close. New fires are being reported. Thanks. Yeah, I know the ship's on fire. I'll put it out, okay? Just chill. Oh my goodness. Yeah, never mind. You're right. This mission is kind of annoying. I still don't think it's as bad as the last one, because at least the premise is interesting and I'm not being blocked by ridiculous things, but I'd have to say, even though I was kind of complaining about the maid one, the thing I was complaining about was just the... Like, it's just like, go find the thing, and you have no idea where. But it at least it wasn't something where I could die. You could fail the mission, but it wasn't particularly difficult. New fires are being reported. Are you kidding me? Whatever, screw the ship. City comes first. No, there's not even one around here. I need another water thing. Somewhere. There has to be one. Somewhere. Oh, up here. Perfect. There's only one more fire. And I have less than 20 seconds to put it out, I think. But I don't see it. Where's the fire? This could be a problem. I don't see the last fire. I don't know where it is. Oh boy, I'm about to fail this mission for a really stupid reason, aren't I? It's hard to see this thing in the way, too. I can't. It's over, I have to redo it. Ooh boy. Screw you, water tank.
Good burn, I hated you all anyway.
Would it be more efficient just to take the fire extinguishers off the ship and just go straight for everything else? Wait, what in the war? Oh, that's right, we have to put out the ship first. Because the city doesn't even show up as an objective until all the fires on the ship are out. Level up to increase its power or carrying capacity. I'm upgrading it because I hate it so much. Things just veer off course from where you throw them, and that's kind of weird. New fires are being reported. I can't find any more water things. How are you reporting new fires? I just put the old ones out. What in the shit is this DLC? Please. I have never heard of a DLC. Well, actually, I have. Never mind. That'd be a lie if I said that. There are so little DLCs in which I can say they sap fun out of the game. This is definitely one of them. We're not even gonna make it this time. Again. Holy shit. A lot of you guys tried to tell me, hey, the carrying stuff isn't that bad, and you know what? It's right. Picking up things and carrying them is not the problem. The problem is having the items auto-track Nevi. You're surrounding a ship with enemies in which what you throw auto-tracks them instead of going to the fire that you are actually pointing at. So you can't choose what target you want to hit when there are Nevi directly next to the fire you need to put out.
I mean, at least Corrin's not in it. That's an upside. Revelations, I think it is, not Revelation. Yes. I couldn't even imagine doing this without, like, my character is... My character's a little OP in this scenario. I could not imagine if you had not grinded. I mean, at least there's not some annoying voice clip that could be playing over and over again like there are in some games. I mean, some games, they just have some sound or a voice or something that will make you so unreasonably upset because it's playing the whole time over and over again while you're failing. I think that's why, actually talking about Dark Souls, I think that's one of the things it does well is it doesn't have the enemies constantly talking to you or yelling at you. Like, the most sounds the enemies make are grunts or yelling at you when they do something. Just like a swing sound, or like their armor will clash or something. In like the original Legend of Zelda, you know that you know how much those of us who loved Zelda 1 so much find that wonderful heart noise. I don't really like many of the Zeldas after it went 3D, by the way. That's just a random thing, and I'll probably repeat that a lot here, but just something I think about a lot because I know. I know a lot of you guys are Pokemon and Zelda, and a lot of you thankfully, or I shouldn't say thankfully because that makes me sound ungrateful to those of you who aren't, but a lot of you thankfully are Danganronpa fans, so when I get to DRV3, I won't just have a complete audience of people who are not knowledgeable of DR2, which is fine, and I hope that DR3 is some sort of separate story that barely connects to 2 and 1. That way, when I go to play it, people won't just be like, what? What? Like at the very end of the game where they try to link all the games together or something. There we go. So all the city fires are out. Now I just have to worry about the ship fires. Is there even a point in taking out the Nevi? Let's just say you know when I'm upset at something or... Finally, thank God. That's the last of the fires. Now it's just the Nevi. I don't care if the government wants to capture them. I can't just let them run around destroying the city. Yes, we can.
Oh my God, this level is complete bullshit, Cat. How are you putting up with this?
Well, maybe they'll let me keep the uniform. That's the whole point of this. I don't care about saving them, really. I just want to impress them, so they'll give us the uniform.
That's the last of them. Oh my goodness. I don't think I've been that upset at a game in a long time.
See, Cat, you disobeyed a direct order. The city was your priority. Soldiers must be willing to make sacrifices.
I'll shove this uniform right up your goddamn ass after all that.
God, my voice is going out so hard.
Sacrifices? You act like a soldier's life doesn't mean anything. Even that pilot you abandoned was fired up to rejoin your cause. But how can people who don't care about their own lives live for the lives of others? Why are you all so eager to die? That's enough, Sea Cat. We're jellyfish. We can't let our personal feelings cloud the bigger picture. Yeah, about being a jellyfish. I know we're both after the same thing, but I'm done with only thinking about the bigger picture. When I see someone who needs help, I help them. End of story. I'm sorry, but I gotta do my own thing. From now on, I'm not Sea Cat. I'm just plain Cat. Spelled with a K. Sea Cat, are you running away again? I told you, I'm just plain Cat, and you're just plain Unica. Next time we meet, that's what I'm gonna call you. I'm not running away. I've just got to protect the city my own way. Goodbye.
He's not even arguing. He's like, damn, I mean, she is making sense. You think about it. We have like a billion soldiers, and I didn't even send one of my soldiers down to help the other soldier out who could have been easily helped.
Yes. Back to the normal costume. I miss my what is it? Ahoge? Ahoji? I don't know how this is pronounced still. It's a little singular hair, whatever it is. I returned my uniform and left the jellyfish in their seal to protect life. They lost the sight of its meaning. Although I may have been done with Yuri, Unica, and the other jellyfish, they were not yet done with me, but that's another story for another time.
Yeah, as I said, there's no way Unica's not going to be a boss battle later. My reputation seems to be improving. Cat's maximum power levels have increased. We can now... We still can't, actually, upgrade Gravity Typhoon to max. But what we can do is upgrade Recovery Time, which I will happily do. So, that's the end of that mission. Wasn't that fun? Or, you know, I'll compromise. I'll do all the ones that are on this city instead of just doing them all.
Cat, is that you? It's been like a year. We were worried sick about you. It's been ages.
Cat, it's so good to see you. We thought something bad had happened.
Newt, Echo, I'm really worried. I'm sorry I worried you. Actually, I have something to ask you. Have either of you seen anything that looks like a giant flying temple or heard any rumors about one?
A giant flying temple? No, can't say I've heard about anything like that. How about you, Echo?
No, sorry. I haven't heard a thing. Oh, hey, where are you guys headed?
Oh, well, we're off to join in some military exercises?
Oh, did you guys join the army?
No, it's part of the new school curricula. Oh, no. I see where this is going. All the students have to go, even if they don't want to, and we don't.
Hush, you don't want any of the teachers to hear you talking like that. You'll be expelled.
Man, Hekseville really has changed. Even the schools are different. Oh, no. This place has gone to shit, hasn't it? I can see. At first, I was like, oh, they're actually just doing their job. But now I can see that it's a total military takeover. And I have a feeling that they're going to be a bigger problem than the Nevi, aren't they? My worst DLCs list. Definitely. Who's this guy? Oh, is it Construction Man again? I thought things would be different, but now I'm out of a job and I got swindled.
Swindled by who?
The new mayor, Denelcia. I thought anyone would be better than that idiot. Bolsey, I mean. Denelcia really looked like a man who would take charge. But all he did was put all his energy into the military, and now the city's a mess.
I see what you mean. I really used to like this place. By the way, has Raven been spotted around here lately?
Raven? No, come to think of it, she vanished around the same time you did.
Oh, I see. I guess she isn't back here yet. Oh, hi, dogs.
We're natural enemies. Oh my god. Listen to that stock barking sound. That's hilarious. The reason I actually put in the dog song in that one episode is because I am pretty sure that is the exact same sound that they used to make the dog song, like in Silent Hill. I'm sure that's the exact same dog barking.
Long live Denelcia. With him in charge, we've got nothing to fear.
This guy's pretty intense. I better back away.
Hail our beloved leader. Hail our proud army. A new age has dawned on Hekseville. Long live Denelcia. Long live Denelcia.
Excuse me? Are you okay?
Are you a Denelcian follower?
Yes.
Oh, good. I thought I was to break both your kneecaps and leave you in the street as a demonstration, but in that case, let's go out for ice cream.
No, I'm good. There you are. I did it. I found your letter.
Huh? Do I know you in what letter?
I found the letter you're looking for. I found it. See, it's from your boyfriend. Dearest love, soon I will leave your side. Though death might part us, our love will remain for all time, forever yours. Oh, that guy. So hard to remember things from a whole year ago, you know. Listen, sweetie, can you toss that for me?
What?
What? But he kept on searching for this letter even after he died, and you sent me halfway down the world to find it. Look, he was a nice guy, but I'm with someone else now. This new fellow's quite a catch, too. He's a real up-and-comer in the Mayor Denelcia's political party.
Oh, you whore basket. You muffin-eating whore basket.
Anyway, the past is the past, right? Bye-bye.
Yeesh, can people change that much in just a year?
The city doesn't look anything like I remember it, too. What happened here?
Okay. Well, my voice can't take any more. Thank you guys for watching. This episode was... Don't get me wrong, when I'm bashing on this game so much, it's because I care about it. Or not this game, but the DLC. The main game so far is fantastic. Dialogue is... It's good. Well written. Character designs are amazing. The art style's great. The soundtrack's great. Gameplay's a little... A little finicky, but it's still good for the first attempt at this. I bet the second one's way better. And I really enjoy the game, don't get me wrong, but it's just these DLCs. They drain your soul away. Like, I don't get upset when something is fair, not that I'm saying it's unfair. I know I say this a lot, but it's just, it's so difficult for no reason, and it's not even doing anything fun. It's some weird time trial management thing, and the game's carrying mechanics are just a bit too finicky for that kind of, I guess I should say, speed trial? I don't know. But thank you for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying this series, because I am too, regardless of my suffering, all episode long. So if you like the video, please leave a like, it helps out a lot and lets me know that you like this series. And if you want to become a member of the Dust Brigade today, click the subscribe button. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Riding out.